Hey everyone! Flipper applications can now easily measure analog voltage signals. This means all kinds of sensors can now be connected to the Flipper Zero. In this video, I'll be using an Atari 2600 paddle controller and a simple circuit to convert the paddle position into different voltages. Everything in this video is available on Amazon, including the Atari 2600 paddle. This video will walk you through making the circuit and installing the application on your Flipper Zero. In a future video, we'll dive into how to make your own programs and we'll look at a lot of different analog sensors. Let's get started. My GitHub has a parts list. First, you'll need a breadboard and then two 220k ohm resistors or a decade resistor board. And then you'll want some DuPont wires, both male-to-male and male-to-female, a 9-pin D-sub connector, and an Atari 2600 paddle with a 9-pin connector. Optionally, the video game module for HDMI output, and to have an HDMI cable connected to my TV. The way the breadboard works, each row of 5 pins are connected together, so each of these is a separate connection of 5 pins that are wired together, top row as well as bottom row. And in this video, we're going to be using that first row for our ground wire. And then a little bit over, we're going to be using for our 3.3 volts. Up above, we're going to be using for our switch. And then down at the bottom, we're going to be using for our paddle. Our 9-pin connector is labeled 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, ground 6, 7, 8, 9. On pin 4, I've connected the yellow wire. On pin 5, I've connected a white wire. On pin 7, I've connected a blue, and pin 8, I've connected a blue. These will both go to ground. So we'll start by connecting those two blue wires from our D-sub into the ground row on our breadboard. Sometimes the pins don't go in very easily, and you can use another hole if you need to. Next, I'll connect the white wire to our C0 row, which is on the far end. This is what's connected to our paddle, and it's variable voltage based on the paddle. And then I'll connect that yellow to a row up above. If you have one of these fancy resistor decade boards, in the times 100K, move it down to it's on the 4, so we have 400K. And then on the 10K, move that down to 4 as well. So that'll be 440K resistor. Then on the end of our decade board, you'll connect a red wire and a white wire. Next, connect the red wire to wherever the 3.3 volts is going to be on our breadboard, and then connect the white wire over to your white section, which is that C0. I like these decade boards because it's easy to change the resistance. I'll go ahead and remove that, and this time I'll show you how to do it with the resistors. So this is a 220K resistor, and when we put these in series, they add together. So we'll have 220 plus 220. So one side will go to where that white wire is, and the other side we're going to just kind of put somewhere. As long as it's in a row that's not being used, that should be good. And then we'll take that second 220. And again, these will add together, so we'll get that 440. One, we want to line up with the same row as where the resistor is ending. And then the second side will go wherever your 3.3 volts is. So this circuit here is the equivalent of when we had that decade connector connected. So we have 220 and 220, and these are on the same row. Next, we have our video game module. We're using this for the HDMI out. The problem is when we connect our video game module to the Flipper, we can no longer access any of those pins. So what we want to do is extend these pins from one side to the other side. And since we're using the paddle, we won't bother extending the accelerometer. So we'll go ahead and start with one of these red wires. And this is we're going to use a female on this first pin here on the right side. And you can see on our Flipper, it's 3V3, pin 9, as the other side that we want to connect this to. So these should all go straight across, basically. The next one we want is ground, which we're going to go ahead and use the one that's 2 down from our power. So we'll connect that. And then on the other side, we can go to ground, and we'll just go ahead and use our breadboard's ground instead of going direct into the flipper. Next, we have the TX and the RX wires. And unlike normal UART where you cross TX and RX, here we just want to go straight in because, again, we're just extending these wires. So skip one spot, and then TX and RX pins are right next to each other. So these two wires should be right next to each other. Again, do not cross them. You just want TX going to TX and RX going to RX. Okay, that should be it for getting our video game module wired up. Unfortunately, the flipper only has one 3v3 pin, so we need to disconnect this and connect it to our breadboard on the 3v3, which is where that resistor was. And then we'll use a red wire from our breadboard's 3v3 onto our flipper's 3v3 pin. So at that point, those are connected. Next, we'll use a blue wire to connect the ground from our breadboard to our flipper's ground wire. And there's lots of grounds, so if you want to connect those all direct instead of using a breadboard on that connection, that would be fine. But we'll go ahead and use this ground here on pin 11. And next, we'll use a yellow wire for our switch. And again, that goes to C1 on our breadboard. And then it goes to C1 on our flipper. And since there's only one wire here, you could also connect the D connector and not connect it to the breadboard. And finally, we have the C0 on our flipper. And that's going to go to that rightmost column, C0 on our breadboard. And that last step is to connect the paddle into our D-sub connector. With everything wired up, it's time to open a command prompt. And then over on my GitHub, we'll click on copy for the commands that we need. And then in the command window, we can right click and choose paste anyway. Make sure that QFlipper's not running, that you don't have lab.flipper.net open, you don't have a firmware updater, web updater running, or any kind of terminal. And also make sure your flipper is not currently running any programs, that you've pressed the back button all the way out to the main screen. And make sure your flipper is connected to your computer. Also, be sure you've backed up any important files on your flipper. This will be replacing our firmware with a custom firmware that we're building right now. And for this part of the video, I've increased the speed 8x. Once it displays this final message of run apps, games, and 2600 Arkanoid, you'll see your flipper is actually still doing a firmware update. You could choose to unplug the USB at this point. So now it's updating our firmware and it's installing that game onto our Flipper Zero. I've gone ahead and changed the speed of this video to 2x so we don't have to sit through the whole thing. Once it's done installing, you should get a message from your video game module. Go ahead and say OK, and then you should see firmware update success. Say OK. Say OK one more time, and now you can go into apps and then down into games, and then you should see 2600 Arkanoid. We'll go ahead and launch that. You see it doesn't say the 2600 logo, so make sure your paddle's turned all the way in one direction or the other. And this time we can see it says 2600, so it's detected the paddle. We can go ahead and say play, and now we can use our Atari controller paddle to control the flipper. Connect the HDMI output from your video game module to your TV, and your Flipper Zero supports the Atari 2600 controller. In future videos, we'll look at the technical details on how to make your own applications and how to integrate with lots of analog sensors. Please like and subscribe, and leave your comments below or on my Discord server.